God is here, and there are people around you. So may I ask you lang, tignan mo lang, makita mo lang yung katabi mo, mga ganun mo lang. Oh. Better still, tanongin mo anong pangalan. Anong pangalan ninyo? Ayan. Tagasaan po kayo. Mga iba, wala lang. Wala. No, you come here as brothers and sisters. Oh, let's go deeper. Tanongin mo, Happy Valentine's. Kumusta ang Valentine's mo? Okay ba? Mayroon na ba? Mayroon pa ba? Now we're talking because we're talking about the heart. Mindfulness starts with you. Question. Your handwriting says a lot about you, right? Ang handwriting mo ba ay straight, 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 ganon? Sabi nila, if that is your handwriting, you are a head person. Kung ang handwriting mo medyo tagilid, pag ganun, you are a heart person. Kung ang writing mo yung parang naka-break, ganun, naku, talagang you're a very, very reserved person. Anyway, today, I like you to be mindful of your heart. How deep is your love? BGs. How deep can you love? You know, when we were seminarians, we taught a simple song, and I'd like to teach this song to you, teach the children. Deep and wide, deep and wide, deep and wide, Jesus' love for me is deep and wide. Deep and wide, deep and wide, Jesus' love for me is deep and wide. Everybody, children, let's do it. Deep and wide, deep and wide, Jesus' love for me is deep and wide. Deep and wide, deep and wide, Jesus' love for me is deep and wide. Oh, Jesus' love for you, deep and wide, deep and wide, Jesus' love for you is deep and wide. Deep and wide, deep and wide, Jesus' love for you is deep and wide. There. Salamat, kumanta na rin ikaw. Isang buwan ka na hindi kumakanta. Little things mean a lot. For some people, who cares? It's all about the head. But for us simple people, the heart matters. That little time you spent singing, maybe put a smile in your face. Okay na yan. Siguro hindi kumita ng pera yon. Nasa puso mo yan. So sisters and brothers, the gospel today is precisely telling us about that. Ang dami kasi silang mga traditions, mga legalism. What the Lord is telling us in the end is, it's the heart. When you give something, you give with the heart. Hindi lang makalusot ka sa mga taxes or whatever. You know, how do you think? Are you a heart person or a head person? Sisters and brothers, be careful. Remember what Pia Wurzbach tells us? Confidently, beautiful with a heart. Mayaman ka ba? Congratulations po. But be rich with a heart. Matalino ka ba? Congratulations. But be intelligent with a heart. O religious ka, madasalin ka, etc., etc. Be religious with a heart. That whatever we practice, kung walang puso, mababaw, empty, vain, it's all for the show and for the money. Go back to your heart and there you will find God. You who are going through relationship problems now, take the journey to the heart. Somebody observe, mga kapatid, the distance from the heart and the head to the heart is just about 1 foot, 12 inches. And some people never make that journey from here to here. All their lives, they are operating here. Hindi man lang bumababa sa puso. Today, I would like to share with you. Whenever I share, it's something I went through. Na nakita ko, nakatulong, baka makatulong din po sa inyo. A lot of our problems, nasosolve naman yan eh. For example, you're lonely. Parang isolated ka. Start asking yourself, baka kulang ka dito. Marami ka dito, marami ka dyan, marami ka dito, pero dito kulang. Heart problem. Baka ikaw ay hindi lang hard-headed, ikaw din ay hard-hearted. Matigas na ang ulo, matigas pa ang puso. You end up lonely. You end up isolated. You miss the beauty of life that God is offering you. So my suggestion is to strengthen your loving, you must have a heart. If you want to love deeply, you must have a heart that is wide. Deep, loving, wide-hearted. That's the formula. First journey, mga kapatid, journey from the road of pride to the road of humility. Marami kasi, Father, huwag yung mga heart-heart na yan. I am a brilliant guy. I'm logical. Okay. But don't let that lead you to intellectual pride. That you even shut off God. Hindi, walang God. Basta ako, wow, I talk to people like that. And it's hard to debate. I just pray. I hope someday, maybe in your deathbed, you realize, hey, there is a God. Kayabangan po kuminsan eh. Maybe it's time to say, let me kneel down. There's someone greater than myself. And some are so opinionated. It's all about their opinions. Itong take ko, Father. Itong take ko. Please, don't forget, mga kapatid. Give God a chance. Whatever you're going through, pati relationship yun na mahirap, magulo na, give God a chance in your relationship and see something happens. Sisters and brothers, there is a God, and please don't forget to respect others. Listen to the opinions of others. Kasi, this could be, the evil one, the greatest tool of the devil is pride. Pag pinasukan ka na ng pride, ang hirap na po makakalas. How do you get out of that? Surrender. Come, Holy Spirit. Number two, sa journey natin, you journey from the works of your hands to the love in your heart. Ang focus mo kasi, I want to live a successful life, meaningful life. Yan ang direction mo. Along the way, I don't care who gets hurt. Basta successful ako, yumaman ako. How about the love in your heart? You end up maybe rich, sikat, whatever, but your heart is empty. I think of parents who were hard on their children. Strict, super, etc. And then in the end, mga anak, mga apo, ayaw nang lumapit. Why? You forgot that they have a heart. Ask the Lord today, sana you live not only a successful life, but a meaningful life. Meaningful yung nandyan si Lord, nandyan mga tao, at mayroon kang service. May natutulungan ka. Loaded ka ba? Materially? Fine. But don't forget, you are lorded. There is a Lord. Don't forget that, brothers and sisters. Third, journey to the heart is the journey of kindness. Beyond who is right, who is wrong, be kind. Maraming away-away natin, tama ako, dapat ito. Ako ang tama, mali kayo. Okay, fine. But in the meantime, you're not kind anymore. Yung bang pinag-aawayan nyo na yan, hanggang kamatayan na yan, why don't you try kindness? Kung head to head, walang mangyayari po eh. Try heart to heart. Doors open, darkness goes away, hearts soften. Heart to heart po, mga kapatid. And one more thing, the road of listening. Do you listen? You keep talking. You kept telling people, dapat ito, ganito, ganito. This is my idea, etc., etc. And what? Believe sila sa'yo? So what? But are you listening to them? Don't go far. Are you listening to your children? I've had many counseling of young people getting depressed, going to hopelessness, even suicide, because you are not really listening. Please, listen. The ear, we have two ears, one here and one here. You put them together, you have a heart. Listen with your heart. May iba kasi makikinig pero naghihintay lang ng pang-rebuttal, pang-sagot, panlaban agad para masabi, ako ang tama. Right or wrong, okay, but please be kind. Ano ba yung mga pinag-aawayan natin? Start with the heart, mga kapatid. And listening to nature. Keep time for yourself to listen to Mother Nature. Ako, I learned a lot about God just meditating on my dog, Bruce. My God, sabi ko, bakit napakabait tong asong ito, napaka-faithful. What did I do to deserve this? He follows me. Anything I tell him, he does it. Pag naglalakad ako, sinasanitize niya doon sa kaliwa, kanan, chinecheck niya raw niya kung security, tapos babalik-balik. Wow. Flattering. You know what I think? That's what God is to us. Ginagawa niyang lahat and we are not really listening. Listen. And listening is listening to God in prayer. Listen to Him, please. Eh kung panay ka kasi dito, overthinking yan. Ang hirap ng overthinking kaya, hindi ka makatulog. Overfighting ka pa and overhurting. Listen to God telling you, anak, I love you. Every day, I pause and I listen to God telling me, Jerry, just love me. Whatever you do, just love me. I am reminded that what I'm doing is because of love. If I do anything, ang dami kong ginawa pero wala namang love, ano yun? Pasikat, payabang, pa-impress. And that's the other journey we should get. From being impressive to be expressive. Impressive ka, pero hindi mo naman ini-express yung pagmamahal mo. Pinasabi mo sa mga anak mo, oh, mga anak ha, sikat tayo, mayaman tayo, magaling tayo. But you hardly tell them, I care for you. What you feel is important to me. What others say is not important. I want to know how you feel. Sana po, forget being impressive. Be more expressive. Oh, now na, mindfulness ulit. Tignan mo ngayon katabi mo, impressive ang dating niya. Wow. Wow. Okay, let's go beyond impressive. Let's go expressive naman. Pakisabi mo lang sa kanya, because you don't know what your brother, your sister is going through right now. Impressive ang dating niya, but you don't know kung anong pinagdadaanan niya. So today, may ask you all, advance Valentine's being expressive. Sabi mo lang sa katabi mo, don't worry, be happy. God loves you. Mama Mary loves you. O diba? Yun na yun. Nag-express ka na. Amen, Lord, amen. Sisters and brothers, people don't care really what you know if they know that you really care. Make people know that you care for them. Expressive. Unexpressive, tanong ko ngayon, is a simple prayer. I always pray, Lord, have I told you lately that I love you? Alagay ko, expressive din kayo. Kantahin na natin. Lord, have I told you lately that I love you? Have I told you there's no one else above you? You fill my life with gladness, take away all my sadness, remove my troubles, that's what you do. Amen? Lord, ah, we told you. Pwede ba kantahin mo yung katabi mo naman? Kayo mga nasa bahay, husband and wife, have I told? Di bali na yung lyrics, basta okay na rin yun, okay? Understood na lang yun. Mga kapatid, thank you po. And let me end today to tell you all, continue to take the road of humility. If some things are not working, alam po nyo, may mga counseling kasi sabi nila, Father, wala na. There are only two things, someone once said. Yung talagang feeling mo wala na, either you give up or you love pa more. And if you decide to love more, no one will blame you. It's your decision. Love pa more. It will happen. The heart, go back to the heart. May honor today a soldier, professional soldier, major general. But he was a soldier with a heart. Whatever you are, you can be a businessman with a heart. Whatever. Please don't forget the heart. Major General Eric Aurelio passed away at the age of 72. Class 72 siya ng PMA. You know, he didn't have much materially. But he had a heart. And he remained to the very end true to his PMA values of courage, integrity, and loyalty till the end. The PMA alma mater song ends with a beautiful, you know, every time I hear that sung by the PMAers, no matter how tough they are, when they come to this part of the song, I've seen a lot of them crying. When the bells are rung and the last tops is sung. When we die, may we all go with the thought that we have served our people well. And we can come before God and say, Lord, mission accomplished with the heart. Sana po tayo rin po, mga kapatid. Please bow your heads, and I'd like to end with a prayer from the morning prayer today, the reading from St. Ezekiel, chapter 36. Listen to the Lord telling you now, my child, I will sprinkle clean water upon you to cleanse you from all your impurities and from all your idols. I will cleanse you. I will give you a new heart and place a new spirit within you, taking from your bodies your stony hearts and giving you natural hearts. I will put my spirit within you and make you live by my statutes. Careful to observe my decrees, you shall live in the land I gave your fathers. You shall be my people, and I will be your God. And to God we say today, Lord, you are my God. I am your son. I am your daughter with a heart. Mama Mary, teach us to love, to live with a heart. Amen.
At pagdating po ng summer, alam po nyo, for little boys, the most important thing are the summer fruits. the fruits of summer. Kung naalala pa ba nyo yung mga inaakyat natin? O ito pag summer, kaimito, star apple, meron yan. Duhat, dumboy, ano pa, kalautit. Ang dami po, mga star apple, of course, siniguelas. Wow, interesting, the fruits. I can remember we were, basta Sabado, yung mga kaibigan ko, si Rino, Manong Ted, Virgilio, Solon, and Ronnie. Fruit patron. Ayan, pupunta kami sa mga, sa school, mga iskaibiti doon. Kukuha na kami mga hinob. Akyat. Pero yung mga medyo hindi pa hinob, tinatakpan namin ng mga, we cover with the leaves para next Saturday, ayos na. Eto na. A few minutes after a few hours we leave, dating palang another fruit patrol. So, it was interesting. But speaking of fruits, you know, question is, kamote, is it a fruit or vegetable? Ewan ko, pero sabi ng isa, Father, it's a fruit. Oh, why? Sabi ko. Eh, Father, res ipsa lugitur. The thing speaks for itself. What do you mean? You eat plenty of kamote, most likely the sound fruit comes out. Kumain ka ng kamote, mamaya nandiyan ang fruit, nandiyan na yung sound ng fruit. Anyway, talking about fruits, I had an interesting experience in Cebu. A priest was beside me and may lumabas na picture message of kamote. You know what he did? He sent another picture message of the okra. Oh, sabi ko, nagkaintindihan kayo? You understood each other? Yeah. Anong message? Sabi niya, kamote, kamote. O anong sagot mo? Okera. Anyway, mga kapatid, okera. But today, we're not talking just about fruits. It's about a fruitful life. What is a fruitful life? Ibig sabihin, pag fruitful, may bunga. Look at your life. Have you lived? Are you living a fruitful life? May mga tao po, panay lang, they're just occupying space. Pero walang fruits. Kung may fruits man, that's the second thing. Are you sharing the fruits? We had a neighbor when I was a little boy. Yung Pepe Olores. He planted a kalautit beside the road. I cannot forget that. All children who pass by, talagang piyesta pag kayong, and it's free. Piyesta. Parang smorgasbord kami lahat basta kasi. And another neighbor we had, he had this kaimito. Talagang gustong-gusto namin, but we cannot even get. And he is always there at the window watching kung mayroong kukuha. Two extremes. Fruitful, yung isa nag-share. Yung isa naman, did not share. Nahuhulog lang yung mga kaimito, falling down, rotting. But he refused to share. You know, ako po ha, one of the most painful things for me is to see food or fruit spoiled, rotting, or not shared. Sayang, talagang, why did we not give this? Ang daming, so, maybe today, mga kapatid, congratulations if you are fruitful. Good job. But, are you sharing your fruits? Mabunga ka nga, pero mabunga nga ka lang. Wala naman palang fruits. Many of us have surplus, excess. Nasasayang lang. May mga gamit kayo sa bahay na it's just gathering dust. So today, please remember, you can say to the Lord, because the Lord, very, very, very pampo itong sa gospel today. The Lord will come and check a vine kung may fruits. At mayroon na rin siyang pamputol. Wala ka naman palang silbi at hindi ka nagbabahagi. Makaputulin ka na lang. food for thought. Lent is the time for almsgiving, sharing. So mga kapatid, assignment. Look at your cabinets. Look at your bank accounts. Kung ano dyan. Sayang kasi kung hindi na ibahagi. Sayang na sayang. And we are answerable to that. Dear friends, another thing is this. Well, mayroon naman dyan who are prayerful. Yun na nga po eh. Prayerful. Is your prayer life bearing fruit? Dasal ka ng dasal, pareho pa rin ang asa. Dasal ka ng dasal, katiting ka naman magbigay. This is what the Lord is telling us. Let us bear fruit. Our time, talents, and treasures. May pabahagi. And we are responsible for that. But the bottom line, if you want to live a fruitful life, it starts with repentance. Repent. In the gospel today, the Lord speaks to us. I tell you, unless you reform, you will have the same fate. Reform. You will all come to the same end unless you begin to reform. Pagbabago po. Let's start with confession. Make a good confession. Or at least you say, Lord, I'm sorry. Tinatanggap ko po. Ako po'y makasalanan. I am a sinner. And you know, ito ha, the evil one knows how to divert us. Makasalanan ka, how about siya? You know, grabe mga kasalanan mo yan. So you begin to focus on others. You compare yourself with others. Oh, mas okay naman ako kaysa mga yan. See, the Lord is telling us, do you think that these Galileans were greater sinners in Galilee just because they suffered this? Please, going to heaven is not a contest. Mas magaling ako, mas righteous ako, I'm more prayerful than the rest. That's very Pharisaic. The Pharisees prayed that way. So stop comparing and just say, Lord, I am a sinner. Period. Once you start with that, you are really beginning to bear fruit. And you will bear fruit. And blame. Stop blaming others. Kaya ako ganito because of you, you, you. Don't play that game of comparing, blaming, and complaining. Otherwise, you'll never bear fruit. And sufferings? Many of us compare our sufferings. Lord, why me like this? Why me? Ang hirap po. It's so hard many times in counseling, you know, all these problems. And then, ito na. Bakit? Why? Why does God abandon me? The easiest excuse always is, why did God abandon me? Hello? Don't blame God. Maybe you have a lot to be responsible for. Because once we have that mindset, we always blame somebody else, even God. Magtatampo tayo kay Lord. You're not facing your real self. So just say, Lord, you are my greatest ally. I will hold on to you. You think you have big sufferings. Last week, I had to talk to a mother who lost 2 sons. 6 days lang ang diferensya. The first son died, COVID, last year, about this time. And 6 days later, the other son died. I mean, what do you say? What do you say? But she said, this is where prayer life bears fruit. When you know that no matter what happens, God will love you and continue to love you. Be strong, please. Be fruitful. And repent, dapat po sustain repentance. Sana yung mindset po natin, kasi may iba, oh, nag-repent na ako, tapos na. Then back to the same old habits. Sustained repentance means I do acts of reparation. My whole life is in reparation for my sins and for the sins of the whole world. I will continue to be good. I will continue to sacrifice because I have sinned. And my life, there is that element of atonement. Mga iba kasi nag-repent pero walang atonement. Atonement for our sins means paghingi ng tawad. So keep that to sustain your fruitfulness. You have to continue reparation and atonement for our sins and for the sins of the whole world. You know, speaking of fruitful life, we just celebrated the feast of Saint Joseph. The man who said nothing. There is no written word of Saint Joseph in the Bible. Wala po. Na nagsalita siya, wala po. Not even a word. The man who prayed. The man who was patient and who persevered. Saint Joseph. This week, I had an experience. I had a talk about Saint Joseph. How to follow Saint Joseph to a peaceful life. That's a topic. Fine. Okay, I prepared. 7 o'clock p.m. Zoom talk. I was ready. I said, I'll just eat later anyway. Guess what? 7 p.m., wala pa yung organizers. 7:15, they appeared. Oh, we still have a little program. 7:30, I was hungry and I was getting angry. But then I said, dasal na lang. So I prayed. Instead of getting angry, I prayed. And I prayed for patience and humility. And you know what? 7:45, finally, we started. I started peaceful na. Why? Because I prayed. Because I prayed for patience and humility. That was the whole topic. This was the whole topic. Saint Joseph taught me to pray, to be patient, and to be humble. On a personal note, the feast of Saint Joseph yesterday is something that we will never forget here in Christ the King. We lost a good co-worker, Leti de la Merced. She was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer February 15, and she was gone March 19. Fast. She left the world fast, but she left behind a fruitful life. On our part, dito po sa Christ the King, we acknowledge her diligence. My God, I've never seen somebody so passionate in finishing everything. Accounts, emails, schedules. Passion. She had passion for work, zeal to help the missionaries. And not only that, she was like a glue. So, pick-up line. Wherever you are, Leti, glue ka ba? Bakit? Kasi you make us stick to each other. The whole community, the priests, the seminarians, there was this lady who was so humble and made everybody come together, work together, blend together. She tamed the roaring lions in this community. She had a way of, you know, making everybody happy and work together. Magaan po. I thank God, you know, God sends angels in our lives. I was able to do in these 2 years two things with Leti's prodding. Father, kaya natin. You know, she gave us vision and encouragement in a light way. Oh, we have the sanctuary of the divine word, the chapel and stations of the cross. I hope you can come visit this sanctuary at the back of Christ the King by the first week of April, God willing. Pwede na po. Mag-stations na po tayo. She worked hard for all this. She would contact, you know, everything, details. And the other thing is social media. She was there when we started. Sabi niya, we have to buy some, you know, instruments, etc. She called people, mga makatulong. You have never seen her, but she's there every Sunday with us. Well, this is Leti. Leti, a simple woman who really shared her time, her talent, and treasure. A fruitful life. The super glue. Leti, till we meet again in the resurrection, thank you for all the help you've given for us, for our missionaries. God bless you, Leti, and Mama Mary loves you. Amen. Amen. So, mga kapatid, question, are you living a fruitful life? Are you sharing the fruits of your life? You know, Every morning, one of my routine is I pray in that little garden at the back of my room. And I inspect all the plants, the vines. So, the Lord also inspects all of us. Kung nagbubunga tayo, He waters, He also prunes. At sana po, ito po, if you don't bear fruits, at least you give a shade. Kung di ka man nagbubunga, at least sana nagiging silong ka, nasisilungan ka. So the bottom line for all of us is this. The bottom line in the end is, fruits from the work of your hands, fruitful, but also fruits with the love in your heart. I pray for all of you, may God bless the work of your hands. Go ahead, but may God also prosper the love in your heart. Be fruitful here. Even those who are suffering, parang, Father, wala akong nagagawa. I'm sick and all. My dear brothers and sisters, your sufferings are a tremendous source of grace and fruits. Your little sacrifices, only God knows them. These are fruits from the heart. And let me end with that. There was a rose. Could you please get that rose? Yeah, brother. And let me end with this. For all of us, I must have shared this before, but lahat po tayo, look, the rose is beautiful, no? But the rose has thorns. Chamiga kashi itta. That's a Korean word. The rose has thorns. What does it mean? Well, my reflection is this. Itong rose na ito, this was a thorn. But it was a thorn that opened up. So it became a beautiful flower. What does it mean? In our lives, we all have thorns. Matinik tayo. Matinik ba yung katabi mo? Oh. But a thorn can hurt people. For example, you have a bad habit. For example, you get angry at people, you shout at people. That's a thorn. That hurts people. That hurts you too. But once you repent and say, Lord, I'm sorry, I want to change, the thorn becomes a rose. Meron ka bang kagalit? Are there people you have not forgiven? Bad relationships. That's a thorn in your life. But once you say, Lord, I'm sorry, I want to change, I want to be well, the thorn becomes a rose. Sisters and brothers, may we be busy making our thorns into roses. That's what life is all about. We are all a work in progress. Keep on. Don't give up. God is a loving God who will never give up on us. So my dear friends, please, we have a lot of still work to do. For many of us, hindi na siguro yung hard work. Medyo, like, you know, you're a senior. I don't focus on hard work anymore. I cannot. Been there, done that. But the work goes on. The shift is from the work of your hands to the love in your heart. From hard work to heart work. This is something that goes on and on. Sisters and brothers, like Mama Mary, may we continue to focus more on the Lord, less on the work of our hands, and more on the love in our hearts. And bless this, our country, especially this time. Lord, may you give us a fruitful election. Good fruits, not rotten fruits. And dear Lord, please bless this world. Don't allow the selfish and the greedy, the manipulators, to rule this world, O God. Saint Joseph, help us to be prayerful, patient, humble, and obedient. Amen.
On SVD, going back tonight to his mission, South Africa. because of the resurrection, because he followed the Lord. One with you, Father Jay. And it's May. May 1. The beautiful month of May. Why beautiful? Well, weather na lang. In many countries where you just went through winter, it's springtime. Oh, you cannot imagine springtime when you've gone through coldest winter. Wow, this is a beautiful time of the year. Well, why beautiful? Fiesta. All over the Philippines, especially in Bohol. Every day, fiesta. Sus kinoo, dagang lechon. It's a time for rejoicing, celebration. And summer vacation. Ayan. Going to the beach, yan na po. And wow, what a beautiful time. Praying that this pandemic will just tapos na. Okay? So, the beautiful month of May. Why beautiful? Well, St. Joseph the Worker. Today is Labor Day. We honor po lahat ng mga manggagawa. Maraming nakakaawa. Sana matulungan sila. Ang dami namang diyang walang magawa sa buhay. Ang dami rin diyang gawa lang ng gawang ng pera. That's all they do. So, we honor the humble, honest, sincere workers. St. Joseph, the worker. And of course, Flores de Mayo. Oh, Santa Cruzan. And Agua de Mayo. The first rain usually comes before May 1. Yan. Many people take a bath once a year, May 1. Agua de Mayo na. And of course, what's more that's happening in May? The elections, yes. I hope it will be a beautiful moment for us. Alam po nyo, lahat po yan, sana po magkatotoo. And you know what's beautiful about May? It's the month of Mama Mary, Queen of May. So, for all this, salute. Let's drink to that. Nako. Speaking of drinks, may expression ng mga manginginom, mga puro-puro gin. Puro-puro gin. Ang karamihan sinasabi nila, oh, one for the road. One for the road ng one for the road. Two for the canal. Three for the hospital. Four for the... But yung one for the road is a beautiful expression. Parang you linger on, you stay for a while, di ba? Like what happened in the gospel. Jesus did not leave the world right away. He stayed on for 40 days. Appeared to his disciples. Nakipag one for the road pa siya. To tell them to be strong. He revealed himself the third time. How many times did he reveal himself after the resurrection? He stayed on. Oh, to strengthen their faith and to remind them of their mission. I look at those as one for the road moments. Kapatid, you know we all need that one for the road moments with the Lord. When was the last time you said, Lord, usap naman tayo. Let's talk. Speak to me, Lord. And listen, please. One for the Lord. Yung one for the road naman, somebody said for us senior citizens, one for the road. Ibig sabihin, you go to the bathroom one more time before you leave the house. One for the road. Baka abutan ka na naman, no? So dear friends, this is something today I like to remind all of you. Jesus is telling us all, be strong and don't forget you have a mission. Importante po sa buhay, hindi lang po yung outlook, magandang pananaw. What is very important in life is the up-look. Panay kang outlook ng outlook. Mga iba dyan, hindi outlook. They are looking out. Sinong latest, anong nangyari dyan. That's all they do, looking out. Don't forget the up-look. moments of prayer, moments of consultation with the Lord. So mga kapatid, yung outlook po natin, ha? Question lang po. One for the Lord, one for the road. Mga iba kasi, one lang. Ako lang. They go through life just me. It's all about me. Kulang po. Life is not just about you. Life is not about me. It's about the Lord. Unless and until you see that, life is so narrow. Wala lang. It's all about you. You have all the money and the blessings. Ikaw lang. Hello? Ang dami po tayo dito, and we have a God to serve. I hope you don't go through life saying it's all about me. Pagharap mo kay Lord, Lord, I had a wonderful life. It was all about me. You've missed the point. One. May iba naman, oh, hindi naman ako one, Father. One for, yun, dinagdagan niya na ng four. Ako, Father, one for the money. Oh, the other one said, one for the show. Popularity, kasikatan. No. Unless and until we come to that point, say, one for the Lord. Then, you have a meaningful life. And maybe that's what I'd like to ask you all today. Ngayon pong paalaalo ni Lord sa ating lahat. Follow me. And the first thing I'd like to ask you is this. Ask the Lord today as the Lord asks you today. Do you love me? Tinatanong tayo ngayon ni Lord. Do you love me? Again, He asks you and me. Do you love me? Eh, most of us will say, Lord, of course, I love you. I love you. But that question, do you love me, has already a condition. You love me if you feed my lambs. You tend my sheep. You feed my sheep. Salita tayo ng salita na, oh, mahal ko kayo. Pero wala ka naman palang ginagawang kabutihan. Sinong naisip natin ngayon? Mga kandidato natin. Tanungin kita ngayon. One for kanino ka? Question today is this. Before the Lord, this beyond politics. Sa akin po, does your candidate love you? Siya ba? Will he feed your lambs? Will he tend the sheep? Will he feed the sheep? Yun lang po. Kailangan po, the most simple thing is, does your candidate follow the Lord or the gospel values? Ano po yung gospel values? Service, true service, honesty. Tapat ba? Generosity, mapagbigay ba? Pro-life, pumapatay ba? Nag-intimidate ba? May mga guns? That kind of a candidate is not following the Lord. So para po sa atin, if you really want to follow the Lord, we have to follow those gospel values. At sundan po natin yung mga kandidato pong sumusunod sa Panginoon. Maybe this is what the Lord is telling us to make Easter happen again in this our beloved country. May mga kandidato kasi, one for the road. Oh, gumawa sila ng road. The road for themselves. The road for their family. The road for their friends. May iba pa nga dyan, they steal the road. Ninako pati yung road na para sa mga tao. Wala nang road. Nako, hindi yan okay nga road. Hindi po yan tama. And dapat po, one for the Lord. Iisa lang po ang ating Lord. Ingatan po nyo yung mga drug lord, yung mga gambling lord. Yan po ba ang mga dapat sundan? If you base it on the gospel, Do you love me? Do you really love me? Do you truly love me? Ito po sana ang isipin natin when we choose our candidates. Vote in conscience, not out of anger or passion. Pinag-isipan po at pinagdasal. That's all. And so, mga kapatid, the Lord tells us, follow me. Follow me. O ikaw, kapatid, may sinusundan ka ba? Is there someone bigger than yourself that you are following? There must be someone greater than yourself that you are serving. Sisters and brothers, remember that song? If you want to be happy, how to be happy? Panahon po nila, Father Jay. True happiness will follow if you only follow Him. Yeah. True happiness will follow. Do you follow this? True happiness will follow if you only follow. True happiness will follow if you only follow Him. Yeah. Yan. So in the end, bottom line, you can report to God and say, Lord, I followed you. It was not easy. Napakahirap po to follow the Lord. Magsakripisyo, magpatawad, maging pasensyosa. It's not easy. Because following the Lord means carrying your cross daily and follow Him. Sana po, this will be a beautiful month for our country. Sana po, fiesta na ang feeling natin. Pagkat nanalo yung mga karapat dapat. Sana po, summer vacation ang feeling natin. And, sana po, Flores de Mayo, celebration. At Agua de Mayo, maligo tayong lahat. So this is what we are praying for. And we are praying for that through the intercession of our dear Mama Mary. Mama Mary, Queen of May, huwag po niyong pabayaan ang aming bayan, especially this time. Sisters and brothers, today again, please bow your head. The Lord is asking you, mahal mo ba ako? Talagang mahal mo ba ako? Tunay ba na mahal mo ako? If you love me, feed my lambs, tend my sheep, feed my sheep. In other words, kung talagang mahal mo ako, mahalin mo ang kapwa. Love one another as I have loved you. This moment, wherever you are, whatever you're going through, the Lord has a one for the road moment with you now, reminding you again, oh, be strong. Oh, don't forget, ha, you follow me, you have a mission. Huwag mong sayangin ang buhay mo para ilang bakasyon. Your life is a mission. Lord, Mama Mary, teach us to follow. You follow you. The way of Mary leads to Jesus. And what is the way of Mary? What are the virtues you follow? Patience, joy, obedience, humility, generosity, kindness. You follow these virtues of Mary and you are really following the Lord. It is the Lord. And whatever you're going through now, you have any problem right now, yes, it is the Lord who is speaking to me. Do you have any worries or difficulties or sickness right now? It is the Lord. You are never alone. So mga kapatid, let's walk with the Lord. One for the road, our mission. One for the Lord. I'm inviting you, by the way, this Saturday, we're going to do a walk. The walk with God to Manawag. 2 years wala po May October. But finally, we'll do it this Saturday, May 7, first Saturday, starting at 5 a.m. alas 5 po ng umaga, blessing sa Urdaneta Cathedral, Urdaneta, Pangasinan. Then we walk, all voluntary, prayer walk, rosary, confessions, going to Manawag, 9 a.m. Mass sa Manawag. To thank Mama Mary for her intercession. Nalampasan natin itong pandemic. And to ask her, to beg her, to give us good leaders in our land. In Jesus' name. Amen, Lord. Amen. One for the Lord. That is our theme from now on. Always one for the Lord. Amen and amen. With September, Christmas is near. For us Filipinos, with September, Christmas is here. Now na. Legit na raw. So anyway, wow, September. It's a beautiful time of the year when the heat of the summer slows down and we cooler weather. I like September, October, November. Oh, try to remember. You know that song? Try to remember that kind of September when life was out and oh so mellow. Try to remember, ha? And para naman sa mga makarelate, yung I'll see you in September. You remember that song? I'll see you in September when summer is gone. Ang kanta ng isa, I'll see you in September when summer is gone. Have the good time, but remember. Anyway, however you sing it, please learn. Go ahead, sing. Keep singing. And maybe that's what a disciple is. The one who sings for the Lord. The one who sings of the Lord. Today, the Lord teaches us about discipleship. Trying to remember, alam po nyo, did you know what I want to become when I was a little boy? Naku, wala pa yung priesthood noon. But as a little boy, I wanted to become a conductor. Bus conductor. Conductor ng bus. Well, ganito po yun. When you were growing up, you drive the Pantrangko buses then. One side is open and aisle lahat yan. And this conductor, I saw him while the bus is in motion. He would go from the front, giving tickets, go back again, getting collection. While the bus is in motion, he was doing all this work. Wow, idol. And I wanted to have, you know, that courage of that bus conductor. Number two, the bus conductor was somebody who cared. Yun ang feeling ko eh, parang, you know, the bus stops, somebody comes in, he goes and gets the luggage, siya magkakarga, mga manok, mga kung ano-ano. Always, somebody goes down, he would be the one to... This guy cared, he served. And third, the bus conductor was the storyteller in the bus. You know, the bus was like 20 people, 30 people. And he would talk, he would tell stories. Oh, this guy was animating everyone during the journey. I said, I want to be someone like that. Yun. Well, I did not become a bus conductor. I became a priest. I became a conductor of the boss. Something like that. And I look at my priesthood simply that. You know, someone who, a conductor, one who conducts people to God and God to the people. Pero maganda po yung word na conductor. Conducere, Latin. To lead with. You were not somebody who was just leading and pointing. You are with the people. That's leadership. That's the conductor. All throughout the journey, we need conductors. People who lead God to His people and the people to His God. We all are conductors. And my work is basically that, serving people, helping people carry their baggage and loading. Shouldn't we all be doing that? And finally, a storyteller. Keep telling stories of God's love, of beautiful values. Ano ba mga story mo? Palaging kinakalat mo ang story, ano nangyari kay sa Facebook, kung ano. Huh? Talk God. That's the call of the disciple. So my dear friends, today, please remember, we have a role. Ang hirap po maging disciple because there is a cost for discipleship. Number one, the Lord mentions today in the gospel, it's about leaving behind father and mother, relationship, possessions to follow the Lord. And number two, carry your cross daily and follow the Lord. By the way, there's no such thing as a perfect disciple. No. There was only one perfect disciple, Mama Mary. She was the first disciple who loved Jesus most. Don't anyone say, I love Jesus more than Mary. She should not be a part of the picture. Hello. You don't know what you're talking about. This was the one who loved him most. We honor Mary. Happy birthday, Mama Mary. Paalaala lang po, ha? Malapit na. And, well, okay. Today, I ask you, what have you sacrificed for the Lord? What have you given up for your God? It's an important question. What have you offered to God? Oh, Father, every Sunday I offer. May offering ako ng katiting, katiting. That's it. That's disciple. God asks more than what your money. God asks each one of us your time, your talent, and your love. Now, seriously speaking, is payback time happening now in your life? God has been so good to you and to me. What are you doing the rest of your life? We will report to God someday. What will we tell the Lord? Sisters and brothers, paalaala lang po. There must be something or someone bigger than yourself that you live for. Don't live just for yourself. That's what discipleship is all about. And it's an ongoing journey to God's heart. We are all a work in progress. Wala pong perfect disciple, but we keep trying to offer. A disciple is someone who offers. We offer. What is offer? O-F-F-E-R. S. Okay, check please. The first one is obedience. Giving up my will to follow God's will. Giving up my desires, my inclinations, because I want to follow what God is telling. And I want to remember that others also need my mindfulness. Not just my will, my way. Discipleship saying, Lord, your way. And obeying. Ang hirap po mag-obey as you grow older. For us in the society, religious. Oh, by the way, birthday of the SVD also on September 8th. Well, many of your students become your superiors as you grow older. That's obedience. Thy will be done. So what is our constant prayer? Thy will be done, Lord. All of us, that's an ongoing struggle. Just keep saying, Lord, thy will. Not my will, but thy will be done. Number two, discipleship is about faithfulness. Pagiging tapat at tunay. Number one po ay faithfulness to God. Ang ganda po ng sinabi ni Mother Teresa, you are called to be a disciple. Not so much to be successful or popular, but to be faithful. Speaking of faithfulness, this morning I got the news that there's a 91-year-old Lola who wanted to join the Mass, Nanay Cristina de Guzman, because she wanted to attend a Mass. That's faithfulness. Oh, by the way, the online Masses are supplementary now. Those who can go to church, go to church. This is now, because the churches are now open. Okay? Faithfulness in little things, mga kapatid. And the other thing is, even with your cross, remain faithful. Kasi mga iba, pag dumating ng cross, wala na si Lord. No, especially when you go through difficulties and trials, that's when your faithfulness really shines. Faithfulness. Stay with the Lord. And the song we are singing is, Lord, into your hands I commend my spirit. Be faithful to the Lord. Be true. And number three, a disciple is free. Try to be free from, to be free for. Freedom from attachments, from your own personal agenda, freedom from your internal prisons, ang dami kang preso, and from external prisons, hindi ka na makagawa ng para kay Lord kasi yun, marami kang preso sa buhay mo. Be free. Sisters and brothers, one more thing po, by the way, you have a cross. How did you carry? How do you carry your cross? Baka tanuin ka ni Lord later on, oh, paano mo binuhat ang cross mo? We all have cross. All of us will have a cross. Paano binuhat? Ah, diyan nagkakaiba. You carry the cross with the Lord. And please, don't pass your cross. Yan yung pass the load. Yung mga bagahe mo, galit ka, so you say, oh, galit ako sa inyong lahat. Huh? Don't pass the load. Pass the Lord. I can hear parents treating the children like this, because of a hang-up they had. Don't pass on your garbage, please. Let the garbage stop with you. Don't pass on your quarrels to your children, your bad habits. No. Be kind. Freedom from selfishness, freedom from attachments. And what's important is if you are free, put God first and above the rest. Above your family, above your attachments, your affiliations, whatever. And a song we should be singing always is, All for you, my Lord. All for you. Para po sa inyong lahat ito, I am free. Number four, disciple is all about being an expression of God's love. Sa pamamagitan mo sana, nai-express yung pagmamahal ng Diyos. You become an instrument of God's peace, a loving presence. Sa pamamagitan mo, nai-express ang Panginoon. Ang problema sa mga ibang disciple, mas focus sila sa pagiging impressive. Nakakalimutan pagiging expressive. To say thank you to people, to say, hey, you're okay, all will be well. Be a someone, not so much a somebody. You know, mga kapatid, focus on expressing God's love, not so much impressing others. Then you become a true disciple. Number five, offer discipleship is about a relationship with your God. Prayer. Kung wala pong prayer life, a disciple is empty, a clanging cymbal. Maingay lang. Kung wala pong pagmamahal, a disciple is just a functionary. May office ka, ganon. Somebody who does this and that. Or a missionary is just a mercenary. Bayaran. The heart, that's what the relationship is all about. And please be someone to people. Not just a somebody. Wow, ang galing, tinitingala, popular, ang daming trabaho niya. But are you a someone to your helpers? Are you a someone to a little child? This is what it means. Puso pa rin po mga kapatid. Saranghe. Maam. Onje na maam. Cheil. Cheil. Number one is the heart. That's for discipleship. And you, a disciple is someone who cares. Sana maramdaman po ng mga tao yan. Someone who cares. Someone who cares. Someone who dares to love you. Pag kumakanta ko, walang nakaka-relate. Kaya sige lang. Yes, and we keep saying, Lord, without you, I am nothing. Claro. Without the Lord, who are we? What are we? It's the Lord. Today, you say now, as for me and for my house, we will serve the Lord. From the book of Joshua. And that's the last thing. S, service. Discipleship is about service, not self-service. And yes, today, families who are joining us now, please agree and tell one another, yes, as for me, for our house, we will serve the Lord. We are disciples. And what we are singing is, did I fill the world with love? Anong kinalat mo habang buhay ka pa? Nagkalat ka ba ng kadiliman? Nagkalat ka lang ng kasamaan? Bottom line is, did I fill the world with love? Did I serve people? Brothers and sisters, again, we honor Mama Mary, the first disciple, the one who loved Jesus most. Many disciples come lately, tell them, wala yun si Mama Mary. You don't know how much this woman shared everything from the very start. That's why we honor her. She will be the first one to tell us, don't adore me. No, only my son. Klaro po yan sa ating Panginoon. And thank you again. Happy birthday to the Society of the Divine Word. We were founded in 1875, St. Arnold Janssen, Germany. And the first missionary, the society was supposed, the foremost mission was mission to China. And the first missionary there was St. Joseph Fernandez. So dear friends, I'm so happy also that here in the mission house, this is the home of 125 Filipino SBD missionaries working all over the world to tell the world of His love. By the way, Jose Juan, the blessing of our Sanctuary of the Divine Word, our prayer park, will be on October 1 already. And the Walk with God to Manawag will be on October 8, all to honor our Mother Mary. So dear friends, we bow our heads. Lord, we are not perfect disciples. We still have so much to learn about true love, true humility. Help us to continue to obey, to be faithful, to be free from attachments, to be free for the kingdom. May we become expressions, living witnesses of your loving presence in this world. May we be someone who cares. May we never forget to be a someone to you. Because without you, we are empty, we are vain, we are proud and shallow. And help us to keep serving, to be conductors. People who serve and who continue to tell the most beautiful story ever told. To be a storyteller of God's love in this world. Mama Mary, teach us. You are.